How you doing? I think I found a place. This is Record Mania, amazing record store. And I think I'm gonna show you all what it's like to actually go digging and why.
Theo Parrish, who comes from Detroit and Chicago, is certainly a producer and DJ whose passion for music comes straight from the heart. Boundaries of genre are pointless to him, and as long as he likes what he hears, basically anything goes. Theo's own productions have consistently set the bar very high while breaking the rules, and the same goes for his DJ sets. Not much is left to chance, so much so that he not only travels to his DJ gigs with full cases of vinyl, but even brings his own mixer and turntable needle. In fact, for Theo, vinyl still remains the essential medium of a professional DJ. For him, digging for records is much more than just part of the job.
It's pretty apparent to me that the format for playing records is playing records, real simple. The advent of technology is always gonna find ways to make things convenient. So it starts with CDs, then it went into the digital thing. Basically, if you have the beginning of any art form, it's like painting. You have a canvas, you have your paints and you have your brush. And yeah, you fast forward the form to today, and you have all these different computer programs where you can mix colors online and move this over there, but it's not the same as having a canvas, a brush, and a paint. There's specific skills that go along with it. So it's very much in the same way. Part of the beauty of a record store like this is you look around and things are pretty visual. You can't get that online at all. You don't get the scale of these. You don't get the improvisational idea of these images jumping out at you, asking for your attention. Because there may be something, you know, you think it's in the rock section, but you pick it up and you may have an idea about rock, a genre-fied idea. You pick it up, it may be funkier than the most funk you ever had. So you never know what you're getting. It's an amazing thing, the store itself. It's an experience. I see that these technological advances have merit in terms of it elevating the artistic form of it. But in order for it to elevate it, you have to see a lot more mastering of that form. So when I see an individual taking the technology and incorporating or moving it past where it's been, which I do see sometimes, but it's rare. I mean, there's examples. You have guys that can go out and play records on a laptop, and then they'll be playing keys and singing on top of it. I've seen Kerry Chandler do that. But most times, it's just using it to replace it because they simply either didn't dedicate themselves to finding the records or they're too lazy. So I'm not comfortable with convenience replacing artistry. That's basically the philosophical thing about it.
Black music, when yesterday becomes tomorrow and sanity slips into the vague past. When the past catches up with you. Black music.
Someone took one of these and another one of these and decided to mix them together. And now that art is somewhat being forgotten because everybody forgot about the records themselves and was worried about the mixing. And that's more about the ego. That's fine that people like to mix and mixing is great and blah, blah, blah. Yeah, and it's important to learn how to do it. But you're doing that only for the idea of a continuous movement of rhythm, that you want everyone to keep dancing or to keep a continuous stream of sonics running in your area.
You don't do it for the ooh and ah, the show of it. My opinion, there's a lot of different types of DJs, and I'll get to that too. But for me, in the way that I know, it hit me, it was the magic of playing music for people, and it being nonstop, and it being honest. And to me, the selection process starts here. You pick out as many different things that are natural to you, that are organic to you, that draw you in specifically. And then later, you refine that process through listening. And then you present it to other people. That's DJing, that's selection to me. It's really simple to be a DJ, but it's another thing to take DJing to a point where you're not just the DJ. How do you elevate it past just playing records for people and being able to beat mix? I mean, they have a beat mix function on some of these things. It's already being done for us. So where's the art coming from? And it always comes from the human. To move forward into the future, you have to know what's going on in the past. Otherwise, you risk redundancy. And who wants to be stuck in a form that keeps going around and around and around and around and around and around and around? You have to know about things that are broken off and splintered here and splintered there and going over there and going over this way and turned upside down so that you know exactly how to do it going forward. Otherwise, you might be stuck in something that's been done already over and over again. And how redundant is that? So you're only being avant-garde or artistic or forward-thinking among a very, very limited amount of people. And then again, also, thinking about the technological part of it too is, until we see an individual that's going to take these technological advances and really do something remarkable, but see, then it has no value. When you still have two people, you're able to do the most basic thing and the most amazing things with those basic materials, you're good. Everything else tends to be just about what technologies we can do. How do we cheapen it and make it easier? I still see that being the attraction more so than extreme artistry. Until I can see someone document certain artists that are doing that, then I'll be more interested. But until then, I'm not seeing. I just see convenience. And that's it. To the role. I just saw something last night, a performance that was the most basic setup, but the music that was going on in was the most way out, mind-bending and twisty-turny thing I've heard in a long-ass time. And this is coming from a quote-unquote R&B artist who uses just a guitar, his voice, a drummer, bassist. So these very simple elements don't necessarily limit the creativity that can come from it. And the thing about the George Clinton and the Kraftwerk thing with, I believe you're talking about Mojo and Jeff Mills and such, that theory was more the idea of being in Detroit and it being about the machine and the obsession about the machine. What I think everyone misunderstood, particularly Europe, was that it's an obsession and an ode to the machine. No, in Detroit, black people being dominated by machine, having to go to work every day, so to the point where your mind is driven by putting the same screw in the same Cadillac every day and breaking out of that by using the machine and escaping. One of the things that really interests me in creation of music and music being played to people is frequency response and frequency isolation. There are certain parts of the frequency range that will hit you depending on what's being played and how it's recorded. And a lot of times, one of the biggest gripes I have is there isn't a big enough range available for people to come hear what you're doing. And that's why I get to be kind of hardcore about the sound systems I play on, and that's why I don't like playing a lot of big places in terms of outdoor venues and stuff like that, because I know that the sound necessarily isn't gonna carry, because a lot of times to make something work outdoors in a big festival, there has to be a certain amount of focus. And without focus, frequencies don't really work. They tend to kind of get vacuous and lost, and like the worst thing in the world is have there be a double venue where you're playing, and then when you, let's say you're working the EQ and you drop the lower frequencies, and that does something to the people there. And then you can hear the other people playing in another room. This, now you've ruined that moment. Now that there's a distraction. And so there's little things like that that people don't think of, because the promoters are thinking money. Those are focus points, and those are very serious. Now when it comes to making music, it's important to not only have it balanced in the headphones, but to listen to it on a scale in which you intend to present it, or at least close, because then it's gonna give you an idea of what you're doing and how you're hitting people.
Said the chemistry is meant to be. Said the chemistry is meant to be.
Chemistry was meant to be.
Being independent is indeed a big topic for me, because let's get down to cultural identity. And one of the biggest issues that I've come across in my life is seeing Black people relying on a larger culture for its own identity, and the neuroses and the violence and the self-destruction that's happened as a result. And those same violent self-destructive tendencies being not only capitalized and sold to the rest of the world, along with its own prehistory of us being subordinate, but now also it eroding our own community to the point where I can't even communicate with the youth. When I was coming up, guys older than me didn't have a fear of saying to me, hey, don't do that. Now I have a general and a valid fear saying to a young guy, don't do that, because he might shoot me because he feels disrespected. Now that is loss of identity. That's loss of individuality. That's loss of knowing who you are and being afraid because a larger culture is sitting there saying, you can't make it, these doors are closed, you have no education, you have no health. So individuality and independence is very important, because I can't look to the larger culture to help me. And so the idea is, I'm gonna do for self, because if I don't do for self, my son's not gonna make it. And because I can't trust what's around and the structures that are there, they're eroded, they're false. So yes, it starts there. And so you move from that and it becomes an independent label. No, I don't want anyone telling me what to put out. Then it goes to independent thinking. No, I don't believe in these lines, because that's binary, that's being controlled. So it's the idea that if you control your own destiny and you decide what you're going to be, then you will be something and you will survive. But if you do not, then you are leaving it all for chance.